minute silence of 30 seconds.
Meanwhile, prayers and some pedal power for a slain friend. Expedito J. De Leon, who migrated to the U.S. from Ormoc City, Philippines as a teenager, was a U.S. Army veteran and a UPS driver for 27 years. He was gunned down during his delivery route earlier this month. Police say the shooter was De Leon's own childhood friend, Rayan Fontanoza, who also worked for UPS. While authorities have yet to disclose the suspect's motive, they say Fontanoza, who was currently on disability leave, used a work computer to track De Leon down to this industrial park in Irvine, California, where in 19 seconds, he allegedly fired 14 shots at De Leon, who was inside his parked truck. Fontanoza will appear in court for his arraignment and a bail hearing on June 10th. He is charged with murder and special circumstance enhancements. A conviction for Fontanoza could make him face the death penalty.
We're in shock. Like, how could it happen to him? It's just like a friendly guy. Super friendly. Like, even if he doesn't know the person, which could be walking around, he would say hi to him. Like, ask them to join his barbecue.
And finally, members of the Asian community gathered at the Chinese Cultural Center in downtown Calgary for the culmination of Asian Heritage Month this May. The event was led by various organizations, including the Asian Media Federation of Canada and the Filipino Arts and Culture Society of Alberta. The colorful celebration featured booths from different communities, offering various products such as food, clothing, and services. Groups and performers shared their talents on stage during the event, including the Sampaguita Lady dancers from the Philippines.
Asian Heritage Month is celebrating the rich culture of all Asian countries and nations that thrive here in Alberta and in all Canada.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
U.S. President Joe Biden begins a new push to court black voters during a campaign stop in Philadelphia. Black voters have historically turned out for Biden and Democrats and were a key reason he beat Trump in 2020. But polls show they could be less supportive of him this year as they face each other again on November 5. Speaking before a cheering crowd, Biden ran through a list of his policy achievements while attacking his Republican opponent.
I promise to put racial equality at the center of everything I do, because I vowed I would have an administration that looked like America. Because you voted, we're invested more than ever in the black families and communities. A promise made and a promise kept. All progress, all freedom, all opportunities at risk. Trump is trying to make the country forget just how dark and unsettling things were when he was president. But we'll never forget.
Black voters make up about 14% of eligible U.S. voters in 2024. Conservative U.S. Supreme Court Justice Samuel Alito rejects request by Democratic lawmakers to recuse himself from two election-related cases after reports of contentious flags flown outside his homes. One of the cases is former President Donald Trump's bid for immunity, and the other, a charge involving the Capitol attack. The New York Times reported that two flags carried by some Trump supporters during the siege on the U.S. Capitol were flown at the justice's home in Virginia and New Jersey. Alito says the flags at issue were flown by his wife, who he said was exercising her right to free speech. He adds the incidents do not meet the conditions for recusal under the code of conduct adopted by justices last year. The United States addressing Israel's action in Gaza before the UN Security Council. Deputy U.S. Ambassador to the UN Robert Wood says Israel must do more to protect Palestinian civilians and remove all barriers to the flow of aid. Wood also citing a ruling by the International Court of Justice, which he says echoes the U.S. position that Israel must avoid a military operation in Rafah that would put huge numbers of civilians at risk.
Israel has a right to defend itself against Hamas.
but Israel also has obligations to protect civilians. The fact that Hamas's leaders and fighters hide among civilians does not lessen the requirement for Israel to conduct its operations in accordance with international humanitarian law. Israel must do more to protect innocent Palestinians in Gaza. We also have emphasized that Israel must connect its military operations to a political strategy that can ensure the lasting defeat of Hamas, the release of all the hostages, and a better future for the Palestinian people. The continued pattern of significant civilian harm resulting from incidents like Sunday's airstrikes undermines Israel's strategic goals in Gaza.
Gaza authorities say more than 36,000 Palestinians have been killed in the war over the past 7 months. Israel says it wants to root out Hamas fighters holed up in Rafah and rescue hostages being held in the area. NATO members must send a signal that they will do everything to contain Russian imperialism. That message coming from Czech Foreign Minister Jan Lipavsky as the military alliance meets this week to discuss support for Ukraine. Russia now holds about 18% of Ukraine territory as it continues its advances in the north and the east.
Defensive alliance. We don't want to change anything on that. On the other side, if we want to defend Europe, we are quite open in recognizing what threatening European defense. That's, in my eyes, Russian imperialism. I'm calling on other states to have a common strategy to contain Russia. And definitely every step which will help Ukraine will also help to this goal.
Foreign ministers of NATO's 32 members will gather in the Czech capital on Thursday and Friday to hammer out agreements ahead of a meeting of NATO leaders in July focused on stabilizing support for Kyiv.